together, yet not too near together. For the pillars of the temple stand apart, and the oak tree and the cypress grow not in each other's shadow.
Taking views on Earth. But we are just a short walk from the Snake River. The Snake serves a very important role in the lives and relationship of Braden and Megan. They were introduced to one another on this very river. As you embark on this voyage that you're about to undertake together, there are bound to be a few stormy seas. And although these problems may cast a brief shadow over your love for one another, it is those little threads that will keep your love from breaking.
Relationships must be like islands. One must accept them for what they are, here and now, within their limits. Islands, surrounded and interrupted by the sea, and continually visited and abandoned by the tides.
You, Braden.
Be my beloved husband.
Be my beloved husband.
The two rings you are about to exchange is the symbol of your union. May these two rings be ever symbolic and unbroken as your love. Just as these rings have no ending, so may your happiness and love be endless.
I am my beloved's. My beloved's is mine.
This is my song.
This is my solemn vow.
Megan, please repeat after me as you place the ring on Braden's. I am my beloved's, and my beloved's mine.
I am my beloved's.
This is my solemn vow. It is with great pride that by the power vested in me by the state of Wyoming and the Universal Life Church, pronounce you husband and wife.
Lifetime of commitment to the loyalty of your friends and to the commitment to each other. We love you, we welcome you, we miss your family, and we wish you they were here, and we are so happy to be here.
Anyway, my toast to you is that you may have a holy marriage. And by holy, I wish for you to grow in unconditional love, forgiveness, and faithfulness.
There's a wonderful quote by Antoine Saint-Exupéry, who wrote The Little Prince, and this is the quote I want to give to you guys. For true love is inexhaustible. The more you love, the more you have. And if you go to draw the true fountainhead, the more water you draw, the more abundant its flow. And that's what I wish for you guys.
In that moment, I was like, oh my God, he's not a frog. He's the prince. Even though it was all, oh, we're just hanging out, it's all casual, I knew at that moment that he was the prince. And so I want to thank the two of you, because I saw on that evening how much love was between the two of you, before maybe you even expressed it or let other people know how much was there. And I am so thankful for the grace and the composure that the two of you have displayed during this very difficult week.
No crying.
Thanks, Karen.
And even though that Megan will always be my Megan, you know what she's doing.
Hey, Tolstoy wrote one time, he said, happy marriages are all alike, and unhappy marriages are each different in their own unhappiness. And I think what he meant by this was that basically it's like, you know, like toasters that work are all alike, you know, but toasters that are broken are each broken in their own individual way. And so anyway, my advice to you in your marriage is like, you know, like, if when something doesn't work, you know, like, you take it apart, you fix the parts that work, and do it all before Megan gets home.